Lynette Pearson, and this is the Video Voters Guide, a service of the League of Women Voters, a 100-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For more election information, be sure to visit our online website, vote411.org, before you mark your ballot. Today, we welcome Marc Woodard, candidate for Tigard City Council. Welcome, Marc.
Glad to be here.
Well, thanks for joining us. Could you tell us a little bit about your background and why you chose to run for office?
Well, my background is quite extensive in terms of city involvement and family participation. My grandfather was a second mayor of Tigard. My father was on the planning commission. And then I served on city council from 2011 to 18. And what got me to run again after I've been off council for 2 years now, but what really got me to run again was the national narrative. I saw what was going on in Portland, the civil unrest, and you know how it's impacting businesses and residents. And I really was motivated to get back onto council based on that, and that we don't have that in the city of Tigard, and that if I can help at all, I want to be involved in the policies that help write that narrative. And if we're looking that Tigard would ever go in that direction, I don't want to see it, and people that I talk to don't want to see it. So they've asked me to run again, and I've got the time, I've got the energy, I've got the experience and the knowledge, and I can start day one.
Fantastic. It's much needed. Question number two. All of us are reeling from the impacts of unprecedented wildfire season in the midst of a global pandemic. Give us your thoughts on how these two crises will affect city government in the near and long-term future.
Well, it definitely has had an impact on city government, all city governments, actually. The wildfires just added an extra layer to things that we didn't need at this point. But inevitably, our forests have been drying out, and the climate has been changing, so you have to address those issues. But it has impacted the city services, and I think that our city does need a little bit of help. And I thought with our city council, I know looks like they're doing a decent job, but I think we can do better in terms of helping to get the word out. I know that each councilor, including myself as a former councilor, had access to social media, access video technology, and we need to be part of the solution to get the communication out. The other thing I thought would be a great thing to do, and I talked about this in 2012, 2013, and beyond that while I was on city council, was a volunteer workforce. I thought, well, why not bring in people that have the skill sets? Unemployment's pretty high right now. Bring them in, offer a stipend to volunteer their time to help city, as opposed to going out and finding new hires. I always thought that parks and recreation, just going off to the side here, could use help with their maintenance and reduce those costs. So I'm still a big advocate of that. And I think those are ways we could help the city get the message out and help with additional services.
Fantastic. Are there other, I'm intrigued by your idea of the volunteer workforce. Are there any other areas that you think that the city could use their services?
Well, I think as far as the homeless goes, I had worked with the homeless committees, Just Compassion's one. So it's a whole network of nonprofits, and actually was the council liaison that not only advocated for a committee for community engagement, but also set the homeless goal. And I think there's a lot of coordination that needs to occur there. And I advocated for a volunteer workforce. And then you've got that in those nonprofits to centralize a committee that could help get services out to the homeless. So our homeless issue hasn't decreased. It's actually increased, and affordable housing is a big deal. So yeah, there's probably every department could use that help. And I think a volunteer workforce is really important.
Fantastic. It sounds like a wonderful idea. Next question. The extreme nature of the political divide in this country has greatly affected the ability of all levels of government to function smoothly. If elected, what will you personally do to set aside ideology and work for the good of the community as a whole?
Well, one of the biggest narratives out there, then again, is the systemic racism and the feeling of being treated unfairly and discriminated against. And I think what you need to do is, I think you need to start with your government, city government, for one, and put together a committee to look at programs and processes and policies that could be interpreted or deemed discriminatory, or if you want to tag the you know, systemic racism to that and identify it that way, that's what we need to do. And as a matter of fact, what I'd like to say, extending out to that point, is I honestly believe that city council needs to be working with the Tigard-Tualatin School District to get with them and see if they couldn't look at their policies, their programs. You know, our kids' values start in school, and how they're being educated and how our teachers are being treated and how they're being hired is just as important as city government. So if we're going to look at one city government process, policies, and programs, we need to look at another system. That's our next generation. And our next generation can help reduce the amount of discrimination, bias out there in the community. So we need to start with our kids first. And obviously, we can start with our government, our governmental programs and processes first. Let's do that first and then work towards the educational system and see if there's something we can do to improve that. So that way, the next generation will treat the following generation even better.
Pay it forward. Thank you. Okay, next question. Aside from the crisis response issues, such as the wildfire, in your opinion, what are the three most important issues facing Tigard?
Well, the three most important issues facing Tigard right now haven't changed since I was on council. And they all go together. That would be the Southwest Corridor rail. It's going to be voted. It's a metro vote that's coming up this November. The second thing is affordable housing down that corridor and within the city of Tigard. And the third thing is traffic congestion. These things go together. So in other words, if the Southwest Rail Corridor doesn't happen by vote or whatever reason, or the federal funding isn't available, the housing choice will still continue and it will still build out, but not to the extent of if the rail came through and that corridor was built out to accommodate more housing density. Talk about traffic congestion. Tigard has a lot of circulation transportation project needs. And without those federal dollars, we don't have the dollars to reduce the congestion that's occurring in Tigard, and growth isn't going to stop. So those go hand in hand. And I would say there's a fourth issue, and you probably asked me that question, but I want to make sure I get that in, is that, by no means, no way do we divest or defund our police force. So you probably asked me that question. I can answer it a little bit more in detail, but that's so important that we support our police officers. So I would say there's four.
Oh, fantastic. We have about a minute left. What would you like to say to voters that I haven't asked you about? Time has just flown, but what would you like to say to them?
Well, I would like to say that I do have the experience. I have the time. I grew up in this community. I love Tigard. I'd like Tigard to remain somewhat similar to when I was growing up and teach the values that I learned as a kid. And we have the opportunity to do that. We can grow Tigard and we can do it reasonably well. And we can build a sustainable city model that includes recreational events that bring the next younger generation in. You know, we can survey and solicit them and get them involved in our committees and committee engagement and outreach. So if you like what I'm saying and you would like to vote for me, please go to www.citizens2electmarkwoodard. I'd love to have your support. I'd love to get back in there. I'd love to help.
Well, thanks very much, Marc, for talking to us today, taking the time. And voters, don't forget to visit vote411.org for for all your candidate and ballot measure information. Thank you so much.